let's talk about my Mac developer setup on my brand new Mac Mini M4 Pro and how I've been able to completely customize it to build for iOS, Android, Mac, Windows, and backend services, front-end web applications, serverless compute, IoT, and so much more. I want to talk you through everything that I did to get my Mac set up and how I replaced this thing, my custom-built PC, with this. Insert Photoshopped Mac Mini M4 Pro here. Let's get into it. Hey everyone, I'm James and I'm back. I exist. This is the channel where I totally do development. I promise you I am here. And I wanted to talk a little bit about my Mac developer setup. I did a recent video up here, up down there, wherever it is, talking about how to get VS Code set up for .NET MAUI application development on Mac, how to install and get all the dependencies set up and everything you need to do. So if you're looking for that, check it out here. I'm not going to walk through like actual installation and setup, but I just want to walk through my Mac, everything that I have here. First, you might be wondering, what is in my Mac? Well, here is the specs. Frank Krueger and I record Merge Conflict, and we also decided to not conflict on getting a new machine, which was our machines were up for sort of a refresh, and we decided to go all in on the Mac Mini M4 Pro and upgrade just about everything. Only difference is I got 2 terabytes and he got 4 terabytes, but we upgraded the RAM, we upgraded the CPU and GPUs, and we upgraded the hard drives as well. Yes, it's an expensive machine, but all of my custom built Windows machines also have been pricey as well, as I put premium parts in them so they last a long time. My Windows daily driver here, I believe, has lasted me at least like almost 10 years, 8 years at this point, which is a great bang for the buck when you think about how long these devices can last. So that's why we went all in on upgrading this model. Also, we wanted to go with something small that fits right on our little desk, and it's so cute. My little Mac Mini M4 Pro here is sitting side by side my Project Volterra, which is another daily driver that I have. So I have 2 ARM machines for both Windows and Mac, which is absolutely delightful. So far, I've been really, really throwing just about every single thing I can at the Mac Mini M4 Pro, and it's been awesome, to be honest with you. There are quirks, of course, as I'm not traditionally a Mac person. I'm more of a Windows person. In fact, we'll talk about my Windows experience on macOS as well. But I want to go ahead and start to walk through my setup. Okay, first things first is that here I am. I'm sort of a high taskbar type of guy. That's right, that's me. But let's take a look at my taskbar down here specifically. So first and foremost, what you're going to see is I just have all of my developer toolchain all set up here. And we can throw just about anything at it. So I can boot up Android Studio over here. Everything that I need. I can boot up Arduino, IDE, so I can do IoT development. There it is. I was recently doing some holiday hacks there. I can boot up Xcode over here. And boom, there it is. I can boot up Xcodes to manage all of my Xcodes. I can boot up the iTerm. I'm using iTerm 2 here and PowerShell scripts to get in with Oh My Posh. So here we go. Let me go ahead and get a little bit bigger here. Boop, boop, boop. Perfect. There we go. And I can boot up other things like DevToys, for example. So here's DevToys, which is an awesome app. It gives you a whole bunch of developer-y goodness right here on your machine. And of course, the thing I'm going to spend most of my time in is Visual Studio Code. Not to mention, at the same time that I have VS Code open, I also have Docker as well. So I can run Docker right here. And what we can see is that I have full Docker running, everything that I need on my machine. I just installed it and I can go ahead and do whatever I want. So there's Docker set up, right? So I'm kind of throwing everything that I possibly can at it. Over here inside of Visual Studio Code, of course, I have all my favorite bits and extensions I could possibly want that I showed in that video, including all the MAUI extensions, Android extensions, Azure integrations here, and of course, GitHub Copilot, which has a new GitHub Copilot free tier as well. So definitely check that out if you haven't been playing around with GitHub Copilot. I use it every single day, all the time in GitHub.com, Visual Studio, and VS Code. Okay, so a few other cool things here is that, yeah, I can just open up, for example, like Android emulators. So here I'm just going to boot up an Android emulator running right there, immediate, right? So if I want to, I could go ahead and toggle this down here. Let me set that as the target device. There we go. I'm just going to hit run. And now my .NET MAUI application is going to be compiled up and then deployed right over to my Android emulator, right? So I have everything sort of in one place that I could possibly want. And now it's going through all the launch. Now, what's nice about this, right, is I'm not only just recording this video, but at the same time, I have all of these applications running. I'm doing a full build compilation. I have an emulator up and running. I have Docker up and running. And I could have a lot more as well. If I go into my activity monitor, we can see that really actually, like, yeah, there's not even that much craziness happening. I haven't even really hit too much here. We are only using like 20% of the CPU, 25% of the CPU. And a lot of that actually is just the Android emulator just kind of sitting there and running, and then our applications deployed, right? So we are doing a whole lot of things all at once on our machine here. So here's our application. It's running just as expected, and I'm good to go. I could come over here and I could, of course, toggle that maybe over to my, I don't know, iOS simulator here. There we go. Boot that up. And sure enough, we're going to get this thing running, and it's just going to boot my iOS simulator as well. And what's really cool about this is that every single tool is running just as we would expect. So if I bring up my Android emulator again, everything is here. So let me talk a little bit now that we have the applications and everything up and running, why I need and have everything installed. So let me just go ahead and minimize this stuff here. Look at all these windows, crazy. Okay, so the first things first here is that I went through my developer setup guide a while back. And normally what you need, of course, is something like, you know, a terminal window. So I have iTerm2 here, customized with Oh My Posh. So I can do all sorts of stuff like, you know, dir, for example, and get all my different like folders, everything like that. I can say CD GitHub. There we go. And I could do CD, let's see, let me LS it. There we go. CD Maui app 1. There we go. And then we can see I have .NET 9 installed on this machine and how long it's taking me to go. So I'm still trying to customize my Oh My Posh, but I installed and I use PowerShell for everything. I love that I can not only just dir, but I can also LS and I just get everything. I just like that. I can use all my commands all at once, which is cool. I, of course, have Xcode over here, and I also use Xcodes right over here to manage my Xcode installation. So here we can see I have 6.1, and I can easily install 6.2, which just recently came out last week. So based on what I need set up, I can go and I can manage, and I can uninstall, reinstall, do anything that I want, and make it my active project. This is nice because it's going to allow me to do Mac development, iOS development, not only in Swift, but obviously also in .NET with .NET MAUI. And of course, if I have any provisioning profiles, it's going to allow me to do everything there. Finally, of course, I have Android Studio down here, which is going to allow me to not only just customize and run my virtual devices, but also manage all of my SDKs that I may need for .NET MAUI development on my machine. So that is why I have Android Studio up and running. Of course, I have Arduino IDE here. I'm using that because I'm working on some IoT devices, things that I've been working on with Frank, which is really cool. So we're doing some different like connections here for YouTube status. So hopefully you'll see that in my background at some point. Now, of course, I also have Docker, as we would expect over here, which is kind of nice in case I start to do some container development with .NET Aspire, for example. Another thing that you might see up here is I have just sort of normal sort of things like Time Machine Backup, Elgato, Control Center for my lights. And additionally, I have something called Better Display. This is an awesome little application that helps me switch between different resolutions easily, refresh rates, screen rotations, color profiles, and a lot more. It was a great recommendation from all of you that have been watching my videos and listening to the podcast. And I'm on a free trial here, and I'm actually totally going to just give the developer $19. I think it's a really great app, and it's better than going back and forth into the settings. Now, one thing you may have noticed down here in all of my awesome tabs that I have open is VMware Fusion. Now, often when we are developing applications, we not only need to develop things on a Mac, but we also want to develop things on Windows. I'm a huge fan of Visual Studio. It's my favorite IDE in the entire world. I use it almost every single day, including on my Mac. Now, there are lots of ways of running Windows on your Mac, and there's awesome new ARM support for Windows itself and pretty much ARM support for everything every single day that you could be doing on Windows. I've been running a Project Volterra machine, which is a Windows ARM developer device for years now at this point, at early bits. Now I have final production bits here, hardware, but I use it every single day at work and personally. Like I have it and I just run just anything. Docker Desktop runs on it, Visual Studio runs on it, pretty much everything runs on it, which is fantastic. So I've been using it every day, and I will say this, that Windows on macOS and ARM all run super seamless together. And that's why I want to walk through what this sort of setup looks like, because I'm actually hopping back and forth between macOS and Windows almost every single day. So the first thing here is there's lots of ways of running Windows, things like Parallels. There's other applications that are out there, but there's also VMware Fusion. VMware Fusion is a virtual environment here. So it's a virtual machine. So it has a big image on disk. And now I am running Windows right here on my Mac machine. You can see it. So it's in one window and it's one sandbox that's there. I can put this thing into full screen mode, and now it's basically like just one full screen, but I'm obviously inside of my Mac environment. So I can pop back and forth. I'm just going to go ahead and set this here. Now, once I have this all set up, I have full control of it. I have a bridge connection, so I can automatically come in here and see under network, for example, here that it is shared with my Mac. So I have full internet. I can plug in USB devices. They're going to show up basically exactly the same between my Windows machine and my Mac machine. So if I plug in an Android device, I can say connect that Android device to my Windows machine. If I want to, I can go ahead and say plug that in and connect it to my Mac device, for example, and do that. So here I can just simply say build on Windows, and now my .NET MAUI application is going to be compiled up and deployed directly inside of my Windows virtual machine here. And now I can do all of my Windows development that I need, which is really awesome. So my application, boom, up and running. It's the same one that you just saw a second ago that was running on my Mac. Now, there are a few quirks, though, of course. Like, I'm inside of a VM in a operating system and hardware platform that doesn't allow nested hypervirtualization as well, which means I can't really just go in here and start up an Android emulator. Now, there are a few cool things, though, is that you can actually just run a few ADB commands. So over here on my Mac, I can open up settings, and here under sharing, I can take a look and turn on remote login, and I can turn on this remote login so I can SSH into this machine. So what I'm going to do over here is I'm going to open up a few little prompts. So the first thing over here that I can do is open up an ADB command terminal. And in our documentation, there are two commands that you would need to run. So the first one here is basically forwarding information packets and making a connection from localhost over to the 127 localhost over SSH. So I'm just going to go over here and I'm going to plug that in. Perfect. I'm just going to give it my password of my Mac. And now I'm actually SSH'd into it. So you can see my Zish over here, which is great. Cool. Now I have that Android emulator that's running over here. So it's up and running. And I'm going to go ahead and connect to it from ADB. So I'm just going to go ahead and hit copy here. I'm going to open up another little terminal window here for ADB and plug that in. Awesome. So now I'm connected. What's cool about that is that now over here, I can see under Android, I have my Android devices that I can go ahead and deploy to. So now I have my Android emulator over here. There it is. You can see the live preview, and this is running on my Mac. So you can actually see that over there. I can click, 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 click. I can see it update in real time. So I get that same dev experience either if I plug in a device or I do something else. And from here, there's a few things that you could do if you want to go to Mac. You could go ahead and connect to your Mac and pair here. You could plug in an iOS device, and then you could do iOS hot restart, which I've done videos on as well. There's many ways of pairing your Windows device to your Mac machine as well. All right, well, there you have it. That is my Mac setup that I've been using so far. Let me know in the comments below what your Mac setup is like, or if you found this information interesting at all, and other questions you may have as I'm starting to like do my development both on macOS inside of Visual Studio Code and also inside of Windows on my ARM device here. I absolutely love it. If you also got a Mac Mini M4 Pro or M4 in general, let me know what your optimizations and customizations have been. I'd be super interested in continuing to like get more familiar with macOS and continue to be more productive as well. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a like, give it a subscribe, do all the things. As always, I really appreciate your support and watching all these videos. And of course, if you're interested in other things in development and .NET or anything else, let me know in the comments. I really appreciate it. So until next time, thanks for watching.